Namaste students, welcome to the video tutorial. This is chapter 6 part 3. Here we'll talk about metamorphic rocks and rock cycle. This video is made to acquaint you with metamorphic rocks. Rocks are of three types: igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic. Metamorphic is a special type of rock which is formed from exposure to intense heat or pressure. So when rocks are subjected to, or they come in contact with intense heat, or they are subjected to lots and lots of pressure, they may change from one state to another. They may become metamorphic. What happens when rocks are metamorphosed? The effects of metamorphism. Rocks can lose their original physical structures, means whatever their physical structures were, whether they were compacted in grains or they were in layers, those layers can disappear when rocks are metamorphosed. So igneous rocks or sedimentary rocks, they lose their original physical structures when they are metamorphosed. Due to metamorphism, the chemical composition of the rocks can also be altered. New minerals can be formed, the old minerals disappear and new minerals take their place. For example, in limestone, it's made up of calcite and quartz, but when that same limestone is metamorphosed to marble, the chemical composition of limestone changes. Let's look at some examples of metamorphic rocks. When basalt is metamorphosed, the rock formed is schist. When granite is metamorphosed, the rock formed is gneiss. When shale is metamorphosed, it becomes slate. If slate is further subjected to heat and pressure, it may convert into schist. Sandstone, when metamorphosed, gives rise to quartzite. Limestone is metamorphosed to marble. Coal, when subjected to heat and pressure, may change into graphite. If graphite is further subjected to heat and pressure, it changes to diamond. Let's look at the sources of heat and pressure that converts rocks into metamorphic rocks. First source for metamorphism is heat. Second source is pressure. Now the heat which is provided to the rocks, or which the rocks get exposed to, may come from magma. Wherever there is magma, it may convert rocks into metamorphic rocks. Heat is also generated when lithospheric plates or crustal plates on the surface of the earth, they rub against each other. This is generally found at transform fault boundaries, which we will study under plate tectonics. Some examples of how rocks are metamorphosed due to exposure to heat is limestone changing to marble, sandstone changing to quartzite, shale changing to slate, and coal changing to graphite. So these metamorphic rocks are formed due to contact with heat. Sources of pressure can be overlying sediments. If the sediments below are compressed by sediments lying above, the rocks may be metamorphosed. In case rocks are found deep inside the earth's crust, where magma is rising up towards the earth's surface, that rising magma may also apply tremendous pressure on the rocks, converting them to metamorphic rocks. Metamorphic rocks will also be found in those regions where lithospheric plates collide with each other. These are the generally convergent plate boundaries. So wherever lithospheric plate collide, metamorphic rocks are formed. Some examples: granite, which is an intrusive igneous rock, when it is subjected to tremendous pressure, it metamorphoses into gneiss. Shale, which is another sedimentary rock, if it is subjected to tremendous pressure, may metamorphose into schist. Metamorphism occurs in two ways. The first one is contact metamorphism, and the second is regional metamorphism. The first process by which metamorphism happens is contact metamorphism. Now let's suppose this is the earth's surface, and the green color and the other color that you see let's assume that they are rocks and the trees are there on the surface of the earth. Now when contact metamorphism occurs, it occurs when the layers of rocks are exposed to intense heat, either by lava or by magma. Suppose magma intrudes through these rocks, then the rocks present here would be burned, and especially the rocks which are located on the edge of the magma and the rocks would definitely be changed into some other type of rocks, means they would be metamorphosed due to the heat of the magma. This process leads to the formation of metamorphic rocks in that edge around the magma. This metamorphism happens due to heat. It's because of the heat that the rocks are metamorphosed. Another way in which metamorphism takes place is called regional metamorphism. In regional metamorphism, large areas of the earth's crust or rocks, they are subjected to metamorphism. For example, let's say this is a crust, and in this crust there is a crack or a fault that has occurred, and you can see that the two plates are coming closer towards each other, so it's a convergent plate boundary. Here the rocks which are found on either side of the fault will be subjected to tremendous pressure, because of which the rocks would be metamorphosed. So this is how regional metamorphism takes place, and it covers a very large area. Let's look at areas where metamorphic rocks can be formed or they are formed. The first regions where metamorphic rocks are formed are near igneous intrusion. Igneous here means the intrusion of magma. So wherever magma tries to intrude into the cracks and fissures of rocks and it cools and solidifies there, the rocks which are present on either side of the igneous intrusion, like the way it is shown here, so all the rocks present here on either side of the igneous intrusion would be metamorphosed. The rock that will be formed where the magma intrudes limestone would be marble, whereas the rocks that would be formed due to metamorphism of sandstone on the other side of the igneous intrusion would be metamorphosed into quartzite. Here the agent of metamorphism would be heat. In mountain belts, wherever two plates collide with each other and mountains are created, in those regions the agent would be pressure. Deep in the earth's crust, so here these rocks which are present deep in the earth's crust can be metamorphosed due to heat from magma, or can be metamorphosed due to pressure from overlying layers which converts them into metamorphic rocks. Look at some examples of metamorphism. Now, rocks can be metamorphosed through regional metamorphism. Rocks can be metamorphosed due to intense heat. So when heat is experienced by various rocks, they are metamorphosed. Rocks can also be metamorphosed when they are subjected to either intense heat and or pressure at a particular place. Let's look at how rocks are metamorphosed in regional metamorphism. This is an example of bituminous coal, which is a sedimentary rock. Now when it is subjected to intense pressure, it will be converted into another type of rock, which is anthracite coal, but this rock would be metamorphic in nature as the density of the rock would increase. Let's take another example of sandstone. If sandstone is subjected to intense heat or it comes into contact with magma, then the intense heat would convert the sandstone into a rock known as quartzite, which will be a metamorphic rock. As you can see here, quartzite is metamorphism of sandstone with quartz minerals. So this is what happens when rocks are subjected to intense heat and they metamorphose. Next we will look at how rocks are metamorphosed when they are subjected to intense pressure. Let's look at examples of metamorphism which occurs regionally, where most of the time pressure is responsible for metamorphism.
Okay, so intense pressure is applied on rocks which metamorphose them. We will have a look at one example of a rock which is known as shale. Now shale, as you know, it's a sedimentary rock which is made up of clay particles. Now due to tectonic movements, if this shale is pushed deep into the earth's crust and it is subjected to intense pressure or heat, more pressure in this case, the shale may be converted into, or would rather it would be converted into, a rock which is known as slate. Looks very similar, but slate is much more denser than shale because the clay particles are compressed. Now if slate is pushed further, it may be pressurized and it may change into a rock known as phyllite. Phyllite, if pressurized more, would result in the formation of schist. And if schist is under intense pressure, then it may turn into gneiss. Now if gneiss, which is very deep inside the earth, if it is subjected to a lot of heat, then it may melt and form magma. This is what happens when rocks are subjected to increasing heat and pressure. They metamorphose.
Okay, let's take a quick look at the rock cycle. Here's a diagram showing the rock cycle in the Earth's crust. What it shows are the different types of rocks and how they can change over time. Let's go through a quick example. Here is a chunk of an igneous rock known as granite. You can see it's made up of intergrown crystals of potassium feldspar and quartz and biotite, and that's what gives it its speckled look. Now, as we mentioned, granite's an igneous rock, which forms from the solidification of melted material, magma or lava. Granite happens to form deep underground from the slow cooling of magma. But the question we want to look at now is, well, what can happen to this igneous rock over time? And there's a handful of possibilities. The first thing that could happen is our granite could be lifted up, forced up from beneath the ground, where it's exposed to weathering and erosion. The wind, the rain, the ice, these forces break this rock down into little small pieces called sediments. So now our granite has been broken into small pieces of granite. Now these little small sediments can be deposited and buried and then compacted and cemented together to form a brand new rock called a sedimentary rock, like this piece of sandstone. So simply by weathering and eroding the granite into sediments and then squeezing the sediments back together, you've converted your igneous rock into a sedimentary rock. But that's not the only thing that can happen to our igneous rock. What if it is pushed even deeper underground by the movement of Earth's tectonic plates, and in so, it is exposed to intense heat and/or pressure, causing it to metamorphose or recrystallize into a metamorphic rock, like this piece of gneiss seen here. So, with the simple addition of some heat and pressure, we've turned our igneous rock into a metamorphic rock. But there's still one more option. What if our igneous rock is exposed to intense heat, causing it to melt and return into liquid state of magma? Well, it can then, of course, cool and solidify again, giving us another igneous rock. But maybe this time it will cool quickly and give us something with smaller crystals, or maybe no crystals at all, like this piece of obsidian. So what you can see is that on the rock cycle, any rock is able to turn into any other rock when exposed to the different processes in and on the Earth's surface. Remember, we start with these three types of rocks. These are our three classifications. And from them, we can go to anything else. Again, let's look at the igneous rock, right? Igneous rock, we know, forms from melting into magma and solidification. But remember, it can melt again, and that process can happen over and over and over again. So I can have an igneous rock that becomes igneous again, maybe a different kind of igneous rock. But any rock can melt into magma and form an igneous rock, as seen on the chart. Sedimentary, metamorphic rocks, they can all be melted and ultimately result in an igneous rock forming. Well, let's look at the sedimentary rock. Now remember, these form from sediments. Sediments that have been deposited and buried, and pressure causing them to compact and cement together. But of course, any rock can be weathered into sediments, and therefore any metamorphic or igneous rock can become a sedimentary rock. Finally, we have our metamorphic rock, and remember, these form when rocks are exposed to intense heat and pressure. But of course, that process can take place with any type of rock, sedimentary, igneous, or even metamorphic rocks. So the key idea behind the rock cycle is the fact that any rock can become any other kind of rock. It can even become itself. Change is always taking place. It's generally slow over many millions of years. However, the results can be impressive. Thanks.
This brings us to the end of Chapter 6, Rocks. Thanks for watching the video. The next tutorial will be on Chapter 7, Volcanoes. This is Jaydeep Mehta signing off. Happy watching.